In previous videos, we explained OWASP's list of top 10 vulnerabilities and Mitre Attack's knowledge base of cybercriminal tactics and techniques. In their own ways, both OWASP and Mitre Attack provide standards to which those with a vested interest in cybersecurity can adhere to, whether that means building defences against likely attacks or understanding cybercriminal capabilities. But there is another framework to consider when informing yourself about best cybersecurity practices, the NIST Cybersecurity Framework. The National Institute of Standards and Technology, or NIST, is an organization dedicated to promoting and improving measurements, standards, and technology in the US. Like MITRE, NIST operates as an arm of the US government, now as part of the US Department of Commerce. In response to executive orders released in 2013, 2014, and 2017, NIST has developed into the framework it is today. The voluntary framework consists of standards, guidelines, and practices to promote the protection of critical infrastructure through better cybersecurity-related risk management. Unlike OWASP's vulnerability ranking system or Mitre Attack's database of attack techniques, NIST approaches cybersecurity on how to implement better risk management. Ultimately, the NIST framework is offered as guidance based on existing standards for organizations to better manage and reduce cybersecurity risk. At its heart, the NIST Cybersecurity Framework aims to present its guidance in a way that applies to organizations across technologies, lifecycle phases, sectors, and uses. As such, the framework relies on voluntary contributions from private, academic, and public sectors, ensuring that it applies to all companies. It consists of three main components: the core, implementation tiers, and profiles. The NIST framework core seeks to establish a series of desired cybersecurity outcomes in a common language that can be understood by everyone. The core is made up of five functions: identify, protect, detect, respond, and recover. Read in this order, the functions set a basic roadmap for organizations to better manage risk. Each core function is further broken down into separate categories and subcategories, which specify additional techniques and outcomes necessary for better cybersecurity in each core function. Also, each core function comes with informative references, which are cybersecurity standards among sectors that illustrate how to implement each subcategory correctly. The NIST framework's implementation tiers then categorize how an organization can improve their cybersecurity risk management based on processes already in place and their business needs. The tiers include partial, an irregular, ad hoc, and reactive risk management approach; risk-informed, focused on risk, threat, and business requirements; repeatable, risk management built as policy and updated regularly; and adaptive, continually improving risk management that utilizes better technologies, lessons learned, or predictive indicators. Lastly, the NIST framework aligns the core functions, categories, and subcategories with implementation tiers into profiles, essentially roadmaps for organizations to follow based on individual business requirements. Profiles are split into current and target to represent changes needed to achieve cybersecurity risk management goals. We have established that the NIST framework gives organizations a blueprint on how to improve their cybersecurity risk management. But how should you use it? NIST framework documentation suggests a 7-step process on how to use their risk management blueprint. Step 1. Prioritize and scope. Establish your cybersecurity objectives using NIST's tier system and the scope of systems and assets they apply to. Step 2. Orient. Identify assets, systems, and regulatory requirements that determine your overall risk approach, and identify vulnerabilities in those assets and systems. Step 3. Create a current profile. Create a profile of your current risk management status using the NIST framework core, category, and subcategory outcomes. Step 4. Conduct a risk assessment. Analyze your operational environment based on your current risk management process. An external vulnerability assessment or penetration test is the best way to determine current risks. Step 5. Create a target profile. Based on the risk assessment results and using NIST framework's core and tier principles, create a target profile that establishes your risk management goals. Step 6. Gap analysis. Establish risk management gaps in your organization by comparing the current and target profiles. Create an action plan that prioritizes work to fill those gaps. Step 7. Implement action plan. Implement the action plan created by the gap analysis in order to achieve your target profile. Use the NIST framework informative references to ensure that your changes meet industry standards. The 7-step process should be thoroughly documented so that it can be easily repeated in the future based on the desired implementation tier. The NIST framework covers the other side of cybersecurity, how to implement a more robust cybersecurity posture from the ground up, rather than raising awareness of potential threats. Given its voluntary contributors and accessibility, the NIST framework can be applied across organizations of all sizes across most sectors. In all, it is recognized as a global standard for improving risk management and developing a reliable cybersecurity program. However, in its aim to be easily accessible, the NIST framework could be criticized for being too general, not offering enough detail on how to technically implement core functions, categories, and subcategories. The NIST framework also falls short in recommendations for multi-cloud security management, an important consideration for any modern-day company. Don't forget to like and subscribe for a notification of the release of our next video, where we will compare and contrast the OWASP Top 10, MITRE ATT&CK, and NIST framework, and how you can use all three together for a robust cybersecurity plan. The risk is real. Defend with Cyber Citadel.